Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our Tenebrae service. Tonight, we will begin our journey into the Easter Triduum as we will accompany our Lord Jesus Christ in his Paschal mystery, in his death, passion, resurrection, and ascension into heaven. And now I invite all to stand and we begin this Paschal. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Our Father in heaven sent his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who is the light of the world. The people that walk in darkness have seen a great light. God is the light of our path. He is the light of truth, and he is the illumination of our salvation. Amen. Amen. Now let us all pray together. Third light. sin. Together let us pray. During the Mass,
reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. It was the Sabbath, and Jesus went to a synagogue where there was a man with a paralyzed hand. Some people were there who wanted to accuse Jesus of doing wrong, so they asked him, "Is it against our law to heal on the Sabbath?" Jesus answered, "What if one of you has a sheep and it falls into a deep hole on the Sabbath? Will you not take hold of it and lift it out? And the man is worth so much more than a sheep. So then, our law does allow us to help someone on the Sabbath." Then Jesus said to the man with the paralyzed hand, "Stretch out your hand." Stretched out his hand, and it became well again, just like the other one. Then the Pharisees left and made plans to kill Jesus. Even when Jesus was healing, there were those who could not accept the power and mercy of God. As the Pharisees left to make plans to kill Jesus for healing on the Sabbath, a little of the light which had come into the world was snuffed out by people Jesus had come to save.
Please stand. And together let us pray. Very loud.
child and distributed it to the people. He did the same with the fish. Everyone had as much as they wanted, and when the disciples gathered what was left, they filled 12 baskets with the pieces of the barley loaves. Seeing this miracle that Jesus had performed, the people there said, "Surely, this is the prophet who was to come into the world." Jesus could sense that they were about to make him king by force, so he went off.
his death. And together let us pray. Very blessed.
When Jesus had finished teaching, he said to the disciples, "In 2 days, as you know, it will be the Passover festival, and the Son of Man will be handed over to be crucified." The chief priests and the elders met together in the palace of Caiaphas, the high priest, and made plans to arrest Jesus secretly and put him to death. "We must not do it during the festival," they said, "or the people will riot." Then one of the 12 disciples, the one named Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priest and asked, "What will you give me if I betray Jesus to you?" They counted out 30 silver coins and gave them to him. From then on, Judas was looking for a good chance to hand over Jesus to them. Betrayed by a kiss from a friend for 30 pieces of silver, any one could have done the one. Jesus came as the truth, but it was too brilliant for those who light the darkness. As the small bag of coins was traded from hand to hand, a little of the light that had come into the world went out.
Thank you.
Together, let us pray. During the Lord's Supper,
you remember the events that led up to the crucifixion. Jesus has been offered to your holy light to the world. But let us accept that there were those who were not with the presence of Jesus at that night. He came to the prayer of the churches, and he knew him. But he knew him also for those who were sick, for not being faithful. And he would depend on that time, they rejected him.
Please be seated for our sixth and final meeting. You are able to please me.
Amen.